You know, except friends just can't let friends share misinformation on social media. So yes, we have to do this. I have to do this. We have to do another meme myth busting episode, breaking down creationist memes. Now, okay, this barely qualifies as a meme because it doesn't really quite hit all the criteria for what a meme is. I mean, yes, it has an image. There is a piece of text that goes with it that says something about the image and is making some statement. But what really is lacking and doesn't make it fully a meme is that the image itself isn't something that's copyable and then editable, or sort of like, you know, you can change it into your own version, right? This is the only version there ever is. There's this image and then there's this text that always goes with it, and it's copied and pasted. So it does fit a meme in that sense, that it is shared, shareable, and is distributed widely among some Facebook groups, Instagram, Twitter. Seen it multiple times. Right. I've given some people a chance, right? I've commented on their Facebook page. I have noted politely what's wrong with this particular image. Well, it's not so much the image as it is the text that goes along with it. Right. But yet again, I see it shared again, sometimes by the same people who have been informed, right? All right, Joel, you know, what's so bad about this one? Really? What's so horrible? Basically, the whole thing's a lie. I mean, I consider that to be horrible. I'm really getting tired of complete and utter lying under the guise of trying to make a statement about what you should believe is the truth. That really bothers me. Okay, let's read it, talk about it briefly. God taught them. Usually there's a before the image, there's a sort of like, isn't nature amazing? Isn't God amazing? Isn't God's creation amazing? Now, usually whoever shares this is gonna make a little tiny comment, something like, isn't God's creation amazing? And, you know, I believe that God's creation is amazing. What I don't believe is amazing is this particular evidence that God's creation is amazing. Let's read it. God taught them, that's why. Amazing! What an amazing discovery. Scientists have discovered that ants, after collecting the grains and seeds that they need for winter, break those seeds down into halves before storing them in their nest. Because breaking them in halves keeps them from germinating, even through rain in the most perfect germinating conditions. But scientists were stunned when they discovered that coriander seeds stored in the ant nest were broken down into four pieces instead of two pieces. After lab research, scientists discovered that a coriander seed will still germinate after being divided into two, but it won't germinate after being divided into four parts. So how do these tiny, tiny creatures know all this? Humans possess limited knowledge. There remains much to be gleaned from other beings. Now, the emphasis here is that these must be intelligently designed. I mean, how could an ant possibly have evolved this ability to know that I need to break, you know, usually I just break the seed into two. I cut the seed into two, and then therefore it won't germinate, and that will protect my harvest. And then, but then how does it know that, for one thing, how does it know that to begin with? How does it recognize that? How does natural selection evolve that particular characteristic? Well, natural selection plus mutations plus other things, right? But then let's up the stakes, right? And the stakes are upped when scientists have discovered that coriander seeds are broken into four pieces, because if you only break them into two pieces, part of it can still germinate. And therefore, the ants have to break them down into four pieces in order to prevent this germination. Isn't that extra incredible? Just amazing, mind-blowing that these ants could find this out. Okay, now when I first read this, all right, I thought, you know, that's interesting. Like, I didn't find this to be like so incredibly stunning that it was proof, right? This is basically a proof of God, right? A proof of an intelligent creator, because only something with greater intelligence than us could have designed this insect with the knowledge loaded into it that it needed to break this particular coriander seed into four parts. That couldn't have happened by any natural process. That I looked at it and said, I have I have no qualms in thinking that a natural process, right? Natural selection, genetic drift, mutations, that those things in an environment over many, many generations would eventually evolve ants that can distinguish different seeds and how to store them in more proper in the best conditions possible to preserve them, right? We could outline a number of different mechanisms for, or a number of scenarios in which that character could evolve under different conditions, under different natural conditions. But that's not where we're going with this. I'm not going to spend 30 minutes trying to tell you how this actually happened, as if to say, oh, right, we don't need God. This is just an example of natural selection, and you just don't understand natural selection, and therefore can't appreciate what God's natural rules for the world can actually accomplish in terms of the variation of ants' capacities and abilities to do things and behaviors. That's actually not where we're going to go with this. What am I most offended about with this particular meme-ish-like thing? Well, when I first saw it, I actually believed what was said here. Oh, there are ants that do this. That's kind of interesting. Like I said, I thought it was really cool. I thought it was really interesting. And so what did I do? I said, I want to know more about this. So I went to look it up. I did a search. I went to Google Scholar, and I'm like, okay, I'm going to find out about these ants. I wonder what scientific studies has been done on this, because I thought, this is really interesting that these ants break it into four pieces. Surely whoever researched this probably has discussed like how they think this has come about. Like are there variations of corianders where some of them they break into two, some they break into four? Like different, does the seed size matter? Maybe there is a particular species of coriander that they do this to, but then other coriander species they don't. Those would all be hints to as how under different conditions with maybe different species of ants, do all species of ants do this? Do all ants break seeds into two parts? I mean, I had questions, like lots of questions. I didn't know that, and I didn't know anything about this. And I was like, really cool biology. It is amazing. I agree. That's really amazing. You know where I'm going with this, right? I did a Google Scholar search, and guess what I found out? I couldn't find out anything, nothing about this. Not only could I not find out that ants break seeds into two parts in order to prevent germination from occurring, but I couldn't even find any evidence that ants even do this, that anyone's even observed that before, much less breaking coriander seeds down into four parts. I searched for coriander seeds. I searched for ants. I searched for ants in storage. I searched for different kinds of seeds. This type of behavior. I've been able to find nothing about this, which of course, as soon as I started to look and it started to dawn on me, oh, of course, I've been totally duped. I've been completely duped by this, absolutely fooled by it. I took it to be real observations. And then we could discuss, do I agree with the conclusion of the observations that this is, if this is true, that scientists have discovered this fact about the world, does this then require that we believe that ants were supernaturally made to be able to do this versus being formed through some natural process? Right? I thought that's what I thought I was going to actually respond with, is the discussion of that topic. But this is just a lie. Just a lie right up from the front. What an amazing discovery. Scientists have discovered that ants, after collecting grains of seeds that they need for winter, break those seeds into halves. Well, there may be an ant out there that does that, but this isn't something that is routinely done by ants. Scientists were stunned to discover that coriander seeds stored in an ant nest were broken down into four pieces instead of two, and that the coriander seeds will still germinate after being divided into two, so therefore they have to divide them into four. Lie. Just a lie, a lie, a lie, a lie. Well, do your research. Maybe you'll find out. Maybe you can discover this research that I haven't. All right. And I'll be happy to make a video, admit that I was wrong, and I'll be fascinated to find out what they actually learned. But I was unable to discover anything behind this. Now, I also went the next step. I said, where did this meme-ish-like thing come from? What is this thing that's been traveling the internet for a while? Well, it's been out there for a couple years now. And it all seems to come down to, this is a while back since I did this. I remember finding out the source, and the source was a particular creationist Facebook group, at least the earliest I could find. And from there, it then has been propagated by a number of different people who have picked it up. But it's always exactly the same. All right, it's the same text. It's the same picture every time. And so this thing has just been shared by so many people. I've seen it in groups where there's been 200 comments, and they're all like, isn't that amazing? I mean, how can anyone believe in evolution or any kind of like natural way that this could happen? This is not possible. And this is just like what I said with last time with meme myth busting and other misinformation that is shared by young earth creationists, or I will say followers of young earth creationists who have a great zeal, you know, for showing what we know and showing that everybody else is wrong, right? They pick up on this stuff, and this is like the next best, greatest evidence. And fortunately, I have some friends on Facebook that have shared this particular one multiple times. And it's just unfortunate because the thing itself, the facts upon which the argument are built are not facts. They're lies. And I say, there must be better evidences for the amazing capacities of God's creation than simply lies. Begin to build your truth upon a lie. You know, it's like building your house on sand, right? It's not going to last. It just isn't going to last. It devalues the witness if what you are promoting and the basis of your argument is based on lies, right? How does that make somebody feel when they find out that this is a lie? When then you tell them, well, you should also believe this, and you should also believe this, and you know, these other things that I hold to be true. I look at that person, I go like, well, you know, were they taken in by those ideas as well? Right? Are they on equally shaky foundations? Right? That's where in this generation of sharing misinformation is so destructive long term. It's like a short term sugar fix. Like, yeah, isn't this really cool? This is a gotcha, right? I can't wait to share this information. And the thing is, I don't blame the majority of people that share these things. You know, they're being shared by a friend that they trust. And so then they share it because they trust that friend. So where does it end? Somebody has to be the one, the bad guy like me, who at least tries to get to the bottom of, like, let's at least share facts. Let's share things that are real, not share falsehoods. We live in a day and age in which falsehoods, like, we have to exaggerate everything in order to have some effect. I suspect that the creator of this particular meme, I don't think they did it as a joke to like get other people to share it, to share lies. Yeah, you know, they probably felt like it doesn't matter whether this is a lie or not. Like the truth of it is real, right? The message is the important thing. And this is where we are in politics, right? In politics, it's like, it doesn't matter how many lies are said, as long as we can get somebody to vote for us or support our policies. Because in the end, we're doing the right thing, even if we have to use lies to convince people to do those things. It's a real slippery slope when you go using the devil in order to try to attain truth and goodness in this world. All right. That's it. We don't need to spend any more time on this. It's simple. The entire thing is a whole bunch of lies trying to use the word scientist as if like, I'm actually supporting science here. Like, I believe these scientists, this is what they found. they just don't recognize who the true creator of this amazing miracle of science is. But again, it's based on lies. No bueno. All right, I'm out of here. Can't deal with this one anymore. That's it. Please let me know if I'm wrong, because I certainly don't want to be sharing misinformation. I will quickly correct myself if I am in fact wrong about the conclusions that I have drawn from my own research of this particular meme-ish like shareable thing, by this meme-ish misinformation. Sayonara, catch you later.